Hey art family, if you like this one, the full-length version is on Patreon.
They are skillful.
Hello art family, and welcome to the new subscribers. For this video, we'll be painting a temple in Hawaii with watercolor. Before I get into the actual demonstration, I wanted to talk about doing thumbnails and the process of trying to break down a photograph or a scene in front of you into the most basic shapes you can. In this sketchbook, I'm going to do a small thumbnail version of the sketch. It's always a good idea to try to do and it can literally be the size of your thumb, but I usually do about the size of a business card sketch of the scene. And what I'm trying to do is consolidate all the visual information into just the most basic shapes. What are the big chunks of shapes that I see? And then break those shapes down into three or four distinct values. So you'd have, like, say one would be white, four would be the darkest, which would be paint, you know, straight out of the tube. And then using some Payne's gray, I go in and sometimes, for this demonstration, I don't always literally mark it, but for this demonstration, I literally marked it, which you can do, which helps a lot, is to just identify each of your value locations so that you can come back with layers. In this case, it's Payne's gray, and just do a small black and white version just to really nail down the simple shapes, because this is the way people will read the image that you're trying to portray. Color is kind of the playground and you can have fun with it, but value is how we really want to anchor the image and anchor the way that people will experience seeing the image. So my goal for the final, no matter what size, will be to somewhat match that very simple breakdown of the value. In drawing, I'm trying to maintain focus on the most simple shapes that I see, the biggest areas, the biggest cubes and ovals and shapes. And I'm looking for little notes in places where, say, the corner of the roof matches, you know, a certain window or a certain point in perspective or a tree, so that I can build the image in perspective based on these tiny invisible horizontal or vertical lines that line up naturally. I'm working up a pool of a gray since it's a gray sky, so I'm getting a cooler and a warmer made of ultramarine and burnt sienna gray, and then I'm getting a small pile of yellow ochre to the side so that I can work my way down from cool to warm in the sky. I pre-wet the whole page, leaving some areas for white, mostly just the tops of the buildings. I'm trying to add some really bright yellow lights, because there's these little yellow accents around the temple, as well as these little lights that look like they're hanging. And I'm leaving in some really light areas so that I can come back later and negative paint around them in the shadows, which will help bring those lights forward and make them much brighter by contrast. I'm trying to treat the whole thing simply and leave a lot of that middle area just a broad light red, so that I can again come back and negative paint in and really give form and depth and shape to the actual object that I'm sketching. I'm using cobalt blue and some cadmium red. I'm using Daniel Smith watercolors, so it's cadmium medium. They don't have a cadmium light red. And I'm adding a little bit of raw sienna to get a little bit of the green to give some sense of light. And I pre-wet the sky above these hills so that it would give the impression that there's this sort of fog drifting over the hills. As I move into these middle ground trees and into the grass, I'm going to decrease the amount of water or white so that there's more saturation, more intensity to the color. As I move from the background to the foreground, I want to increase the saturation, increase the value of my colors, and warm up some of the areas of the tree so that they get the sense that you get the sense that there's a separation there, and some atmospheric perspective, so that those hills are pushed back and the trees and the grass are drawn forward. I'm working my way around the sketch, trying to find the lighter areas that aren't stark white or stark light, so that I can add in just a little bit of tone and some value and start to subdivide these large shapes into smaller shapes. I'm bringing in a lighter red now, and I'm starting to get concerned with the drawing a little bit, but not too much. I'm mainly just putting in a light red area that I can come back in later and detail in, but this area will represent the lighter parts of the wood that are sticking out that are red. I'm still trying to consider everything in its largest shape possible for where I'm at, and I'm adding some red to the water to get that sense of reflection. A lot of times with water you'll get a really strong sense of reflection, like almost a mirror, maybe slightly darker than the actual object you're sketching. For this one there was a lot of green and a lot of kind of semi-darker value, so I'm trying to give the red so that I can have more of a suggestion of a reflection than a direct reflection. In retrospect, I kind of wish I would have pushed that reflection a little more, because you get a really interesting look and a very compelling look with water when you kind of enhance the reflection that you actually see. I added some saturation and intensity to the trees behind the temple because I wanted to give more of a separation so you could tell that those trees weren't that far back in the distance, and to give some texture and some form to them. I'm adding in some lines that are slightly darker while the water is still wet, so that it has a very soft edge and it sort of dissolves into the water, just to give the sense. I took that darker value and I started to work in these tall trees behind the temple. In retrospect on this one, I kind of wish I would have had a little more water in it so that they were slightly lighter. I think they came out a little bit darker. It's hard with watercolor because it tends to dry a little bit lighter than what it goes down as, so on that one I kind of overdid it with the darkness, but I don't think it takes away from the sketch. I'm starting to now subdivide again into a smaller section and take concern in the actual drawing of this temple and the individual little pockets and windows and underfacing planes. As I go, I'm using ultramarine and burnt sienna, as well as red or raw sienna, depending on the parts of the wood that I'm trying to show, or the area where I'd want to have more warmth, where light maybe is getting bounced all around. The light is diffused on this one. If it was directly lit by sunlight, we would have a lot more light being bounced up into the underfacing planes, but because it's diffuse light, we're getting a lot of very soft shadows, and we're more concerned here with the local color of objects. And if you don't know what local color means, that just means it's the color that's like the inherent color of the object. So like if you have a red apple, its local color would be red. I'm working my way into these rich kind of dark sort of soffit areas, or these under parts of the roof, where but as I go, I'm continuing to be concerned with the slight and subtle shifts of warm to cool constantly. So we're using burnt sienna and ultramarine as the base for this black or this gray, this dark color, and so as I go I have the two pools, and I'm constantly shifting between burnt sienna and ultramarine to get a constant sort of ebb and flow of warm and cool as you move throughout the sketch. One thing I'm about to adjust for is I felt like the sidewalk was kind of competing with the roof, so I'm coming in and adding some very uneven texture, as well as adding just a little bit of texture to the planes facing outward on the roof since it curls, just so you get more of the sense that there's a curl to it, that there's a plane that's facing upwards towards the sky and outwards. I'm also trying to find these small, slightly grayer plane changes in the roof, just to add them in to give more of a sense of the volume of the roof. And now I'm trying to find a way to sort of recess parts of the temple so that you get the sense that some parts are coming forward and some parts are pushed back in space. I'm adding in this darker shrub in the foreground using, I believe, viridian and carmine, and then some yellow ochre or raw sienna as well, just to give the suggestion of these shapes, this darkness, mainly to draw focus towards the center, because I didn't want it to compete with the center of the object I'm trying to sketch. So I'm adding this sort of darker area to knock this area down to relieve it of its importance. And I'm adding figures now around the temple to give some scale to the sketch, as well as importance, because people like to see people. Well, that's it for this demo of this Buddhist temple in Hawaii. I hope you got something out of it, and I'm always here to talk shop. I'll see you in the next video. In the meantime, happy sketching.